Hello and welcome back to another iteration of our Time Sticking YouTube channel. Today's featured topic is going to be about a really unique collaboration between a world leader and a famous watch brand. So stick with us through our intro and we're going to cover the subject with you today. One particularly famous but unlikely fan of high-end watchmaking is the 14th Dalai Lama, Tenzin Gyatso. Now, as unlikely as it seems, folks have been acknowledging his penchant for fixing and rebuilding mechanical machines ever since he was dubbed the spiritual leader of the Tibetan people years back. His known love for the art of mechanical hands-on labor has led him to be gifted well-built timepieces from international fans around the globe and throughout history. Indeed, the Dalai Lama doesn't necessarily rock fine mechanical pieces for fashion. Often sporting inexpensive bands on otherwise pricey pieces, his main focus, according to interviews, are on fixing and maintaining these watches. Since we work on watches here at Time's Ticking, it's kind of exciting to hear that such a well-known world leader shares a similar taste for watch maintenance. Though it's rumored that he has a pretty extensive collection, we're going to focus on some of his main collaborations, as we mentioned in our intro. The gifting of watches goes very far back for the Dalai Lama. Back when Swiss watches were seen more as utility than a luxury item, young Tenzin Gyatso was gifted a Patek Philippe by Franklin D. Roosevelt. Not to date His Holiness too much. The year was 1943. World War II was still going very strong, and the US needed a road over Tibet. What better form of diplomacy than a perpetual calendar reference 1526, the supposed Patek Philippe model? This pocket watch was the beginning of a long history of receiving watches from various celebrities and heads of state who learned that young Tenzin Gyatso was incredibly intrigued by mechanical engineering. The Dalai Lama's current collection boasts somewhere just above 15 watches. Aside from his original Patek Philippe, his most notable watches are his Rolex Datejust and Rolex Day-Date watches. Day-date watches from Rolex appeared back in the 1950s and were the first automatic mechanical watches to have both the day and date on the dial. A pretty good reason for Tenzin to take one apart and see how it works. Though these watches are relatively opulent, Tenzin Gyatso tends to keep things pretty low-key, so much so that most of his other watches remain a mystery to even the keenest of horological eyes. This 14th Dalai Lama is pretty inclined to mechanical movements, especially finely built Swiss ones from brands like Patek Philippe and Rolex. However, he was gifted a unique Casio watch recently. That's right, a more comical addition to His Holiness's watch collection came from the late night TV show host John Oliver. Back in March of 2017, Oliver landed an interview with the spiritual leader for a segment on Tibet's relationship with China on his HBO show Last Week Tonight. While the interview remained primarily on that topic, John closes the interview by offering Tenzin Gyatso a gift, a Casio calculator watch. Oliver cites the original FDR Patek Philippe gift and offers his own timepiece as a sign of respect. And what was the Dalai Lama's response to this? He says that perhaps the Roosevelt watch is old-fashioned and that the Casio calculator watch is new-fashioned. To this, Oliver responds, paraphrasing, "Well, it's from the 1980s. We're not sure what Tenzin would make of the quartz or digital movement compared to his mechanicals, but he accepts the gift with as much grace as anyone could expect from such a big-time spiritual leader. Considering that the Dalai Lama is supposed to be very non-materialistic, some folks may draw the conclusion that his watch collection is too excessive or goes against his doctrine. And to be sure, someone who's supposed to be dedicated to a life of ascetic spirituality seems out of place wearing a thousands of dollars valued wristwatch, with the Casio aside. Despite appearances though, which he keeps well muted by wearing inexpensive bands and his dials on the bottom of his wrist, Tenzin Gyatso's passion for his timepieces goes well beyond their monetary value. Considering that most of them are gifts, after all, his intentions bend toward the meditative side of life. By practicing the deconstruction and reconstruction of their movements, he draws inner wisdom. So much so that in his 2001 book, Ethics for a New Millennium, he wrote on how he's learned to overcome certain frustrations through the art of watch care. It's something that we here at Time's Ticking can relate to, on a personal level. On that same note, in interviews, the Dalai Lama has said that if he was not born into his role, he would have liked to be an engineer. Maybe in his next life, Tenzin Gyatso could get a job with us. That is, of course, if he doesn't ascend to nirvana and leave this world entirely behind. Is there any particular timepiece that makes you feel a sense of nirvana? Are there any other celebrities you'd like to see us cover in our YouTube channel? Let us know in the comments below. We love to hear from you. Hello, and thanks for watching our YouTube video today. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like, and you can find similar videos right here. For more new and interesting content from Timesticking on our channel, please subscribe at the link here. And for more information about wristwatch repair and watch maintenance generally, you can find us at timesticking.com. Thanks so much and have a great day.